Hello, welcome back to my channel Dad's Princess Things. In this HTML tutorials, we have seen many things till now. Today we are going to deal about the HTML class attributes. Let's see what is meant by this class attribute or why we use this class attribute in HTML and what is meant by class attribute, whether it is useful or not, how it is useful. Let's see this kind of things here. So HTML class attribute, this HTML class attribute is used to specify the class for an HTML element. We can specify a class property or attribute, we can say, to the HTML elements. Why this class we have to give for an element is we can use those class whether to style those elements or whether to give any special preference to that elements. We can use this class attribute. So multiple elements can share the same class. Not only the single element have to be a single class element, a single class name, or have to be different or unique. Not like that. So multiple HTML elements can share the same class name. Multiple elements can have the same kind of class name for them. So using of this class attribute, why to use this? So using this class attribute, so often we can use this attribute to point a class name in a style state. That is, if you are gonna apply any styling properties to that particular element, or you can say the HTML element or tag, so that tag is having a class attribute, with the class attribute giving a specific name for the class. So that class, by using those class names, we can specify that in the style state, and we can apply different kinds of styles to that particular HTML element. So that we can also use this class attribute. It is can also used by a JavaScript to access and manipulate the elements with a specific class name. Not only to apply the stylings, but also we can use this class attribute to use it for the JavaScripting. We can access the particular element by using this class name in the JavaScript to manipulate that element, how the element will change based upon the manipulating things. We can use this class. In the following example, we have three div elements. In this example, we have three div elements with the class attribute with the value of city. We can say here I am having a div element 1 and 2 and 3. In this div element, I am giving a class attribute. With that class attribute, I am giving the value of city. We can see here the same city name we have given as a class attribute in the class attribute for these three divs also. Same class we are giving these things. All three div elements will be styled equally according to the city style definition in the header section. This period dot class name will be the syntax for applying a particular style to that class element. We have to follow this syntax, that is class name. That is what type of class name we have specified in with this class attribute in that particular HTML element. That name will be comes here in the style attribute. It means style tag I am applying here is the internal CSS. In this internal CSS will be in the header tag with the style tag. In that, in the style tag, we are giving the that class name. In that class name, I am applying some stylings like properties like background color and color white for the text, and border I am giving 2 pixels and solid black, and margin also I am giving 20 pixel and padding 20 pixel. I am applying this these stylings for the class of city here. I am having a class of different classes like city in the three different parts. So the styling is applied to for every div here. So let's see the example. You can see here I am giving background as tomato color, text will be the white and 2 pixel for the each thing border, and next solid black color border, and next margin 20 pixel, and padding for the text to the border will be 20 pixel. So like this, everything is applied same. We can also change this by changing the class name different. We are giving the same stylings, applying same styling for the different elements by using this city. Unlike we can do these things. Likewise, you can do all these things, and also we can use the span elements with the class attribute. Not only the class attributes used in the div elements, but we can also use inline elements like a span element. In the span element also we can use this class attribute. The value of the class attribute can be of anything which is a user defined. I am here using a name of a value of the class will be a note. In the span element, you can observe here span class is equal to note. In that note, I am giving something. I am styling based upon this class name, that is the period dot class name, that is dot dot class name. In that, I am giving specific properties for styling purpose. I'm giving that as a fixed font size as 120%, color will be the red. The particular span which is having a class name note will get these type of properties for the styling purpose. See the example, then you can get a clarity on that. Yes, I'm getting this example. I am giving a H1 heading. In that, I am giving a specific span. In that span, I am giving a class attribute. In that class attribute, I am giving the class name as note. By using this class name, I am going to styling it in the internal styling. That is by using the style tag. In the style tag, I am specifying a dot class name note, that is colon, and I am specifying the properties of font size and color as red. So the things will go on. Next, we can change different stylings here. Different colors we can apply, and we can give a text decoration like this, and many more things we can give here. Next, class attribute can be used in div and span. So that is all about this class attribute. And next, what will be the syntax for the class and how the things will go on? Let's see once again. To create a class, write a period dot character, means period means dot character, followed by the class name. Then define the CSS property within the curly braces. See how these things are going. The style, I am giving a dot means period character to that, followed by the class name. In that, I am applying the CSS properties within the curly braces. That CSS property will be applied to this element which is having a class called city. So that is all about syntax of the class we have to give, follow. And multiple classes having the same name. Multiple classes can belong more than one class. That is, we can see here, to define multiple classes, separate the class name with the spaces. That is, here I am giving the class is equal to city main. The element will be styled according to the all the classes specified. So means, here you can see, the following example, this is the h2 tag belong to the city class, and also the main class, and we can get CSS styles both of the classes. Like not only the city name I'm specifying main as also name for the class. Like I'm specifying the space. By giving the space, it will consider that as a different names. That is, not only the class name is single name, but also I'm specifying that as main also the class name there. See the difference. Like these things will help us to understand the bootstrap also. In the bootstrap also, we have to use different types of class names in a single class attribute. So like that, here also I am specifying the city name and also main name for this first heading, London. So you can see the stylings which is applied by using the city class and also main class is both applied to this first H2 one, that is one London text. I'm giving the background color as tomato and color white for the text and padding 10 pixel. And also I'm in the main tag, I'm applying text align as a center. So you can see I'm giving the style and main for the London. So background color is tomato and text will be the white and the padding will be 10 pixel. And it is a text align will be the center. That is, I'm applying main class styling also for this London. And you can also see I'm applying main tag for this Paris also, like here you can see. Now this one also changes to the middle one. Likewise, we can apply only single class name or also multiple class name also in the by using the class attribute. So this is multiple classes we can say. Next, different elements can share the same class. Like different HTML elements can point the same class name. As we have seen previous example, that is city is given for here I am giving H2 tag also. For P tag also I am giving the class name is same, that is a city. So the city stylings which you have applied in the CSS will go for these two HTML elements we can see here. So not only the particular paragraphs or headings we can say, we can use different types of HTML elements for the same classes. So you can see I'm city applying for the same paragraph also, and for the heading also Paris, and here you can see P paragraph, same city tag, city stylings will be applied for those two things. So use of class attribute in the JavaScript. Not only the class attributes used for styling purpose, we have discussed that it really useful for JavaScript also. That is to manipulate the elements, like how they will react and how they will work. So we can also use class attributes for this purpose. This class name can also use it for JavaScript to perform specific tasks for the specific elements. That is, some elements have some properties or specific tasks to perform. So that things will be done by this class name. JavaScript can access elements with a specific class name with a get elements by class name. Like we have a one method called get elements by class name. By this method, we can get the elements. Now we can get the elements by using the class name. We can't get that. For example, we can say get the element by some p. You have to get the element of paragraph. We have so many of paragraph. We don't understand what particular paragraph you want to get. So in that case, by giving a specific class name for that particular element there, by using those class name, we can retrieve the get the element of the HTML by using the class name. So by using this method, get element by class name, in that class name we have to specify the class of name of that particular element, so that we can retrieve the specific element here. So this is the example of JavaScript. If you understand the JavaScript, then you can understand these things. So script, in this script function, my function, here I'm giving a var x is equal to get element by class name. I'm getting the element of having the class name as ct here. On that element, I am making the changes of some operations are performed based upon that element. So let's see this example. I'm giving height for button. I'm giving on click. It has to go to the my function. In my function, I'm getting a city called. So if you wanna understand these things, so you have to basic knowledge about JavaScript. So I'm not discussing about JavaScript functions and many things. Just understand about this document get element by class name. So not only the class name is used for styling purposes, but also we can get the HTML elements in the JavaScript by using these class names. So that is the thing we have to remember here, and we have to discuss here in this HTML classes. So up to now we have seen many things like class attribute and how to use this class attribute and what will be the syntax and how different names will be applied, multiple classes how I have to apply, and same classes name how to be applied, and the class name is a case sensitive, we have to be keep it in the mind, and different HTML can point the same class name, and classes are used for by CSS and JavaScript to select and access the specific elements, and Java Script can access elements with a specific class name with the following function called get element by the class name. By using this method or this method, we have to get the access to the specific element by using the class name. So class name is very important for the HTML elements. For better purpose of making the things a class name, we have to better to use this class attribute and specify the particular name for the specific classes. So that's all about today. HTML class is very main topic, we can say, in the HTML tutorial. So by using this class attribute, we can specify the classes for the particular HTML elements, and we can make use of it in the styling purpose or JavaScripting also. So that's all about today, all about HTML classes and class attributes. So if you like this video, give a big thumbs up below, and if you have any doubts regarding this class attributes and many things, you can discuss with us in the comment section, and feel free to comment. If you have any suggestions regarding to these tutorials and anything, you can feel free to suggest us in the comment section, and share with this video with your friends to make the learning process easy. And subscribe to my channel for many more videos like this, and click the bell icon below to get notified each time when we upload a new video, so that you will never miss another further topics, important topics will be when we upload. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.